स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम राजा चौहान फ्रॉम लक्ष्य इंटरनेशनल स्कूल महेश्वर। टुडे आई एम गोना टीच यू चैप्टर नंबर 3, क्यूब्स एंड क्यूब रूट्स। इन अवर प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव कंप्लीटेड 3.1 एक्सरसाइज ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। नाउ वी विल सी अवर नेक्स्ट एक्सरसाइज इन 8th मैथमेटिक्स। So our first topic, we will see first concepts which we are using in 3.2 exercise, cube roots. Finding the cube root is the opposite operation of cubing. The symbol for cube root is, that is, what is the symbol? Root, and here you have to write 3. The same as square root symbol, but 3 written in the stroke as shown. Okay, so like this is the sign of cube root. Now, as you all know, 2 cube will be, what is the 2 cube? 2 into 2 into 2, that will be 2 into 2, that is 4, 4 into 2, that is 8. Okay, so now 8 cube root will be 2. Okay, so like this you have to find the cube root in exercise number 3.2. Now we will see prime factorization method. Okay, so suppose one question is given 216. Now we have to find cube root of 216. So first we will use prime factorization method. Now 222, 333, these are there prime factors. Now you can see we can make the pairs of 3 numbers, that is 2 into 2 into 2, the pair of 3 numbers, and 3 into 3 into 3, that is the pair of 3 numbers. So we just have to write 216 equals to 2 into 3, because we make the pair of the 3 numbers. So 2 into 3, that is 6. So the 216 is a cube of 6. Okay, so when we find cube root of 216, we will get 6 answer. Okay, so like this you have to solve. Now estimating cube root means we have to find nearest to cube root. We will see in the question. Now we will solve exercise number 3.2. Question number 1, find the cube root of the following: 85184. Okay, so 85184, first we have to use prime factorization method, means in LCM. Okay, so when you will write the factors of 85184, it will be 2 into 2 into 2, then 2 into 2 into 2, then 11 into 11 into 11. Okay, so you can see we have made here 3 pair of these. So we can write root cube root of 85184 equals to 2 into 2 into 11. Now 11 into 2, 22, and 22 into 2, that is 44. So the cube root of 85184 will be 4. Okay, so you have to solve these questions. Now question number 2, by which smallest number should we multiply the following numbers to make them perfect cubes? Find the cube root of the perfect cube. First question is 30375. So first we will write the factors of 30375, which we will get about from prime factorization method. So 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 5 into 5 into 5. Now you can see we will make one pair of 3 into 3 into 3 and 5 into 5 into 5. 1 3 is missing here. Okay, so we can multiply by 3 here also and here also. Okay, here we did it. Okay, now you can see when you will multiply 30375 into 3, you will get 91125, and here 3 into 3 into 5, the cube of 9125 that will be 45, and the 91125 will be the cube. So like this, you have to find by which number you have to multiply and which is the nearest perfect cube of that number. So like this you have to solve this question. Question number 3, by which small number divide the following numbers to make them perfect cube? Find the cube root of the perfect cube. In previous question we use multiply, now here we have to use the divide. Now our first question is 6655. So first we will write the factors. You can see we can easily make the pair of 11, but 5 is only 1 5 is there, so 5 must be divided. So 6 5 divided by 5, and here also divided by 5, then 5 is completely easy. Now when you will divide 6 6 5 5 by 5, you will get 1 3 3 1. So cube root of 1 3 3 1 will be 11. Okay, so like this you have to solve this question. Here you have to just divide by the number, and in previous question we just multiply by the number, both side multiply you have to do. Okay, now question number 4, find the cube root of the following. Now first question is -343. Okay, so for -343 again you have to take prime factor. You can use the division method or prime factorization. Now 7 into 7 into 7, so 3 minus 3 4 3 equals to -7. Okay, minus because in question also that there is a minus sign. Now in the same manner you have to solve this question. Question number 5, find the approximate value of the following. Cube root of 700. Cube root of 700. We know that cube root of 8 is 512 and cube root of 9 is 729. Okay, so the 700 is in between these two numbers. So now you can see when you will minus 700 minus 512 you will get 88, and 729 minus 700 you will get 29. So you can see the difference, 29 is smaller, so our cube root will be the nearest 9. Approximate value will be the 9. Approximation value we have to find, because you can see 88 is greater than 29. So we will our answer of approximation value of 700 will be 9. Now question number 6, estimate the cube root of the following. 3500. Now 3500, the nearest one is 115 and 16, that is 3375 and 4096. Now 0 minus 3375, 125 and 4096 minus 3500, that is 596. Which is more? This one, because 125 difference is there. So 15 will be the estimate value, means estimation value, okay, approximate value we can say. Now find the cube root of the following, 4.096. Now 4.096, first we will remove the decimal point, then we will get this one. Now you, for both the numbers you have to write the, now you know that 1000, that is 10 cube, and 4096, that is the 16 cube. So 16 by 10 will be the 1.6. this will be our answer. So like this you have to solve this question. Question number 8, find the cube root of the following. First you have to multiply 125 into 2 and then plus 93, you 143 125. Now you know that 343 is the cube of 7 and 125 is the cube of 5. So 7 by 5, this will be our answer. So like this you have to solve this question. Now question number 9, we have to show that cube root of 27 into cube root of 64 equals to cube root of 27 into 64. Okay, so cube root of 27 is the cube root of 3 and 64 4. Now 27 into 64, that is 1728, which is the cube root of 12. So 3 4 equals 12 and equals to 12. LHS equal to RHS, hence it is completely, means we show that the LHS is equal to RHS. This is complete. Now in the next question also we have to solve 12 equal to 12 and 50 equals to 50. Now question number 10, the volume of cube is 12.167 centimeter cube, find the length of its edge. Now as we know, the volume of cube equals to side cube. Okay, so edge cube equals to the given value which is in the question. So we have to find out the cube root of 12.167. So our answer will be 2.3. Question number 11, same here, h cube equals to, means 17.576 cube root you have to find out. Okay, then you will get your answer, that is 2.6. question number 12, the volume of cube is double the volume of cuboid with volume 6.912 centimeter cube, find the length of an edge of the cube. So volume of cuboid is given. Now volume of cube will be double, so we have to multiply it by 2, so our answer will be 13.824. Now we know that volume of cube is h cube. Now h cube equals to 13.824. Now when we transfer cube to RHS, it will become the cube root, that is 13.824. Now when you will calculate this one, you will get 2.4 as answer. Now question number 13, the volume of cube is 1.331 centimeter cube, find the length of its edge. If the length of its edge is doubled, by how many times will the volume increase? Now first we have to find out the edge. So as we solved in the previous question, likewise we have to find out the edge, that is 1.1 centimeter. Now if the edge is doubled, so 2 into 1.1, that is 2.2. Now volume of cube you have to find, so 2.2 cube you have to find out, then you will get this one. Now let the increase in volume be x. We have to find out how many times will be the volume increases. Okay, so x in 1331 equals to 10.648. volume of cube is 10.648 and the given volume of cube is 1.331. so when you will divide both these number, you will know how many times the volume will increase. So when you will divide, you will get 8. Okay, 8 is answer. So 8 times the volume will increase. Now question number 14, the volume of cube is 0.125 centimeter cube, find the length of its edge. If the length of edge is increased 3 times, tripled, by how many times will the volume increase? So first you have to find the cube root of 0.125, that is 0.5. Now if the length is tripled, so 3 into 0.5, answer will be 1.5 centimeter. Now 1.5 volume you have to find, means 1.5 cube, that will be 0.375. here you have to write 3.375 centimeter cube. Now so let the increase in volume be x, so x into the given value, that is 0.125 equals to 3.375. now 3.375 will be divided by 0.125. when you will divide this, you will get 27. So volume will increase by 27 times. Now our third chapter, cube and cube roots, are completed. Now in the next video we will see chapter number 4. Till that you have to practice all the questions of chapter number 3. Thank you and have a nice day.